Today, I'm going to show you how to schedule appointments optimally with Quarkus and Timefold AI. Let's get started. So you go to code.quarkus.io and we create a new application. Let's call it Timefold Quarkus Demo. And we're going to pick a number of things here we want to have. Specifically, what I want to have is the Timefold extension. So I'm going to use the Timefold Solver extension for Quarkus, and I want support for Jackson. All right, here we go. And let's see if that's enough. Do we need a bit more Jackson things in there? I think by default, we get the classic Jackson things. So let's actually use this one. Here we go. And we generate our application. Let's open up that application in IntelliJ. So here we have the Quarkus demo application, and I'm going to go into the sources, and you will see here we have a greeting resource, which we can actually use to create our schedule. So this is going to produce a string right now, and let's change that up with an actual schedule. So the first thing we need is we need to have an appointment class. So we're going to create a class called appointment. And in this class, these are the appointments we need to assign to starting time. So every appointment will have a name. All right. I'm going to, for example, an appointment with the doctor or with the dentist and things like that. Every appointment will also have a duration. All right. And so, of course, we're using the java.time library here. And every appointment will also have a starting time. All right. And here we go. Now, every appointment also has an end time, but actually, that's actually just a start plus a duration. So actually just add a getter for that. Let's say, okay, the end of an appointment is the start plus the duration. Simple. Okay, now we're actually going to give this to Timefold, and Timefold will fill in the start for us. So that means that when we create test data for this, we can just say, okay, we just need to give it the name and the duration, but not the start time, because the start time will be filled in for us. But for Timefold and for Jackson, we actually need a new R constructor too. So let's add that too. Talking about Jackson, to send this to JSON, we will also need to add getters and setters on all of these fields. So let's just do that, right? Okay. Now, we want to tell Timefold, you can fill in the start time for us. So to be able to do this, Timefold needs to know that this is a class that it can change. And we do that by annotating it with a planning entity annotation. And to say specifically which field can change, which is the start time, we need to say, okay, this is the planning variable. This is actually changes during planning. And you need to fill in the best start time for each appointment. So that's exactly what we've done here. Okay. But of course, we'll be sending more than one appointment to our AI solver. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a schedule to contain all of those appointments and also all of the possible start times. So here's our schedule class. And this will basically have a list of appointments. All right. And this will also have a list of the starting times. Start times. Here we go. Now, we need to be, this is what we'll send to over the wire also. So let's actually give that an empty constructor for Jackson again. And then to create our test data, let's give it a constructor where we give both the list of appointments and list of start times. And again, for Jackson, let's also just give it a bunch of getters and setters. Now, we also want to give this to Timefold. And this is actually where Timefold will, this is the schedule that Timefold will optimize. And the problem actually gets and the solution it creates from that is called a planning solution. So this is a schedule we will give it. And in the planning solution, Timefold needs to know, okay, where can I find my planning entities? So we just tell them, okay, the appointments, that's your planning entities. That's a list of appointments we want you to fill in. So that's our collection of planning entities. And this is the property that holds them. And then, of course, we need to tell them, okay, what are the start times you can pick from for each of the appointments? And this is our value range. So we'll also only allow him to pick appointments during the day and not during the night and so forth. So we'll only fill in start times that start during the day. Okay. One more thing. This thing will have a score. And the score is how good or how bad these appointments are being assigned to those start times and how well they conflict with, how much they conflict with each other. And so that's the score. Typically, you would use a hard soft score for this. So let's actually add that too. And then Timefold will fill that in for us. Again, we want the score to show up in our JSON output. So let's add and get there again for and set up for Jackson. Okay, here we go. We have our schedule class. So what we can now do in our greeting, we can now say, okay, this is the REST method. We can actually say we're going to return a schedule here. So let's open it up for a second. Let's create a dummy schedule. Here's a dummy schedule I've prepared in advance. I'll walk you through it in a minute. This is a problem with a list of appointments. And I've created three appointments already, a doctor's appointment, a pub appointment, and a barber appointment. You can see they have different durations. The doctor appointment takes 1 hour, the pub 4 hours, and the barber 70 minutes, which is a little bit longer than 1 hour. We can pick from these times to do these appointments, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, or 6 o'clock PM, of course. And you can already try solving this in your head. But I'll give you a little hint. If you start the pub too early, you will not find a feasible schedule. So it's not that easy to just solve this blindly. You actually you have to think a little bit. So let's return that from our REST method. So this will need to become a schedule, and the type of this will need to become location JSON. Now, before we send that back, we will actually want to solve it. So what we need for that is we need a solver, a solution manager. A solution manager is the thing that will solve the problem for us. So we're going to say, okay, please, Quarkus, inject me solution manager to deal with schedules, and the type of IDs for that, for the jobs I send there are actually type string. And here we go. We have our solution manager. Of course, we need to inject it. So now, this is solver manager. The solution manager is also quite interesting, but the solution manager is if you want to evaluate the quality of a solution, we need to inject the solver manager here specifically. So with the solver manager, we can now solve this problem. We can say, okay, I'm going to send you job one. This is the problem I'm going to give it to you. And then we will get a solver job. And this will normally solve asynchronously. What we want to do in this case is just to get the solution immediately. So you want to wait for the best solution and return that, and actually return that into as return in our REST method. So this throws a few exceptions because this normally happens because this waits for another thread, so it can be interrupted and things like that. But for now, we'll just add those methods to the method signature to not deal with them. In a real application, you would want to deal with them properly. But you would also probably not wait until the schedule to be solved during your initial call. You would actually have that solve in the background and then come back to look at the solution every once in a while. Okay, this should work except for one thing. We don't have any constraints yet. Now, that's fine, but we do need a constraint provider. So I'm going to create a simple constraint provider called my constraint provider. And I'm going to implement the constraint provider interface and just define no constraints. So right now we're going to solve the schedule without any constraints. We do need to tell the solver how long to solve. And so let's just say the quarkus.timefold.solver can get 1 second to solve in this particular case. And we add that in the application properties. Okay, it's ready to run. Let's run that. Run the Quarkus Timefold demo. To see it starting up right now. And we will just go to that method here, /hello, and that will solve it for us. So let's go to localhost, /hello. Here we go. And as you can see, it just solved it for us. And it returned back the JSON form of our schedule. Now, what you see here is that all of our appointments are actually assigned to a start time. So even though our test data did not assign them to a start time, after solving, they are assigned to a start time. They are all assigned to a valid start time, one of these in our value range. But they are actually not this is not a good schedule, because if you can see, we need to go to the doctor at 3 p.m., but we also need to go to the pub at 3 p.m., and also to the barber at 3 p.m. Obviously, Timefold doesn't know that you don't want that to happen. You need to tell them what your constraints are, and that will change from your business case to a different business case. So let's go back to our solver, and let's actually just go into our constraint provider, and let's actually add a constraint for that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add a constraint overlapping, overlaps, and here we go, and we create a new method for that. And normally, if I would do that properly, I would also immediately write a unit test for that, and we have support for that, so do check that out. But in this case, I'm just going to write it directly. And I'm going to say, in my constraint provider, I'm going to say, when I have two appointments that are overlapped, that's a bad thing. So what I'm going to do is give me any unique pair of appointments. And I'll talk a little bit more about that, but let's say we have two overlapping appointments, then we want to penalize that as a hard constraint. So don't do that. Don't ever do that, please, Timefold. And we're going to give that a name called that it's overlaps, right? Now, as you can see here, we use a for unique pair constraint that basically says, select me two appointments. Now, the problem is it could select the same appointment normally. How can it know that it selects the same appointment twice? How can it know that it selects two appointments, A and B, and then also selects the reverse pair, B and A? That's not a unique pair. So we need to actually tell them, okay, we need to give them some sort of hint to how to make that unique. It's quite simple. Our name is unique on the appointment. In more elaborate cases, you would have an ID. So we actually tell them that's the planning ID. That makes that appointment unique. And then we can actually use this particular construct, the for each unique pair, to get two unique appointments. Now, on top of that, we also need to say, okay, they're overlapping. Now you have two appointments. That's could be fine as long as they're not overlapping. So let's actually say what happens when they're overlapping. So the nice thing about that is that Timefold has direct support for overlapping. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a joiner, say select me all of the appointments, all of the unique pair of appointments which are overlapping. And in this particular case, the overlapping function needs to know, okay, where can I find the start and end of an appointment? So I'm just going to say this is the start, the appointment could start, of course, and then the get and the appointment end is the end of the start. And now it will make sure that all that the two appointments it select are indeed overlapping. And when they're overlapping, we're going to hit Timefold on the head. Stop doing that, please. And let's take a look at how that rolls out. So we go in again, we solve it again. And now we can see that everything is solved again, but you can look at the starting times, they're actually different now. And as you can see, we have no hard constraints broken. So let's take a look at that soon. Okay. The start time of the doctor appointment is 3 o'clock. It ends at 4 o'clock. The barber starts at 4 o'clock, ends at 5 and 10. And then the pub starts at 6 o'clock and rolls all the way into the evening until 10 o'clock in the evening. So as you can see here, it actually created a feasible schedule. Now you can already see some of the soft constraints here, like do we have enough time to go from the doctor to the barber? We might want to add some more time in there. Let's see if we can make that happen. And by adding a soft constraint, you will actually get the doctor appointment to happen before the barber appointment before the doctor appointment. But that's for another session. You can try this out yourself. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about Timefold, go to timefold.ai. And if you want to learn more about Quarkus, go to quarkus.io.